What's the future of UCITS, the European fund investment vehicle that's been used globally by asset managers and their investors? Recently, ICI Global and the Center for the Study of Financial Innovation co-hosted a dialogue around that question. And afterwards, I got some key takeaways from the panel moderator, Andrew Hilton. So Andrew, when you think about the discussion that went on this evening, what are a couple of the cross-cutting themes or comments that stand out to you?
Well, I think I was more concerned about the level of concern that others had for the whole Brexit negotiations, where it's going to end up. I am broadly optimistic, but it was quite clear that the panel wasn't, that there's a lot more concern about what's going to happen to the fund management industry, what's going to happen to Brussels itself, and you know, there isn't much wiggle room in the negotiating position, I think, of the EU 27 at the present time, and the level of concern around the room was quite high.
So Andrew, thinking about all the consistency you heard, what also surprised you?
Well, I think the level of concern surprised me, and also the unanimity of the feeling that there aren't really too many easy answers. This is going to be very difficult. It's going to be difficult to set up. You clearly can't set up brass plate operations. It's quite clear that fund managers from third countries are already looking at London and saying, well, maybe not. Maybe we'll put our business somewhere else. London, therefore, is under threat. London is under threat, not immediately, but over time, the attrition is going to erode London's position. Now, at the end, you know, you ask the panel what's going to happen to London in 5 years, and the general consensus is that, oh, it'll be okay. It won't be as big, it won't be as powerful, but it'll be okay. But, you know, I think that in a way was a sort of heroic end of the debate, where we say, well, it really isn't going to be quite as awful as we told you it's going to be. But the whole tone of the debate was more pessimistic than I expected.
And so, Andrew, knowing that you run a center that studies financial innovation and has a particularly strong city focus, how does this conversation begin to move forward in your mind? What will your view be going on from here?
Well, I think we're looking at it on a day-to-day basis. And it's quite clear to me that at the moment there isn't goodwill. If there were goodwill, the Brexit negotiations could be concluded very quickly. But without goodwill, we're not going to conclude them at all. Within a couple of months, I think the negotiations are going to cease to focus on the deal and they're going to focus on the transition. Can we have a lengthy transition period? And I don't know what that transition period will look like, but there's no way that we can get a deal by, it's not just March 2019, which is the final deadline, but we have to give the European EU 27 at least 6 months for its parliaments to ratify any agreement that we have. So we're looking at the middle the autumn of 2018. We can't do a deal that quickly. That's quite clear, and I think, therefore, you know, that London is at risk. That's a pity, because I'm sort of quite enthusiastic about the sunlit uplands, the life after Brexit, but at the moment, Brexit itself looks very difficult.